please, we don't want any fans left. They're all able to note. Oh yes, and there's some packets of seeds there that have come from seeds in our garden. If you're travelling back interstate and you're not allowed to take plants, or you don't want to take stuff on the plane, all right, so there, that's there. So, these labels were too good to throw out, these labels. So I'll finish, and then it's dessert. Right. I just want to say my 70 years so far has been better off than most people. I really feel that I've been blessed, privileged and incredibly fortunate. I was loved by my parents, I'm loved by my wife and children, as you can see, and all of you friends, which is just super special. So thank you very much. Added to that, I've had really good health, apart from that bit of a help heart thing 6 years ago, but that's all gone. I have a sense of humour, which I'm very grateful for. Reflection tells me a very positive disposition and a contentment with life. So I really feel incredibly fortunate. And on my office door, up at Allgate, and where I am now, I have a notice that says, be yourself, everyone else is taken. And I'm very happy to be myself. I'm very contented. But of course, I realise that at 70, I'm recycled. And which suits me fine. The other day on the radio, they were saying that 70 is the new 50. And so that's okay. But then someone else said life begins at 70. So I'm not sure what the last 70 years have been, if it's just beginning. But thank you. The decades game, getting into those groups, allowed me to speak of my link with you, and it was only brief for everyone. But again, I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you, because each one of you is very special. Now, Helen and I have had 45 years of marriage this year, and in a way it's been a Helen and Colin and Helen Rolfe's team. And we've often laughed and said, if you want a funeral, a wedding or a party, we can conduct it, do the flowers, do the music, cater, clean up and charge. Between us, we can work it. So, and in a way, that's been our life. Our gifts have been very complementary, and people often marvel that we can work together in the kitchen. But we can work together in the kitchen, and for many, many years, many happy years, we cooked at Beach Mission, and also we catered. Helen, of course, has put up with my messiness, my lack of decisiveness, and my disinterest in holidays, and I've often said to her that she married the wrong man because of that. But in Christian ministry and family life, Helen has been just wonderful. She has her own gifts, of course. People assume that I'm the minister and that's it, but Helen is great with music, hospitality, an excellent Bible teacher. And when people ask her now, what do you do? Because, you know, people always say, what do? As if you've got to have a job. Well, she now says, I do people. And she does people very well. We've always considered that we've both been full-time workers. It's just that one of us got paid at different times. And together, I think, we have lived very richly on one income. And we have been delightfully happy with that one income. Yes, we're recyclers. Yes, we're careful with money. But we're also very satisfied with what we've got. We don't need the newest thing every 5 minutes. And that suits us fine. And often when we talk about situations, it's compare ourselves with people who have less rather than comparing ourselves with people who have more. And in that way, we are incredibly, incredibly wealthy. Now, it doesn't mean, of course, that we've always agreed. I think one of the things that took quite a while to come to agreement with was the lights in the family room. We've got a fairly high-pitched roof, and we just had 3 light globes hanging down for about 8 years until we could agree on the light fittings that we had. And it was sort of like a passive resistance situation. You know? Anyhow, when we finally decided and had them put up, And the kids came home and they said, "You're selling." They thought that after 8 years, we were actually about to sell because we bought these light things. But no, we've had really a great relationship and a very happy working relationship. As I say, we don't always agree, but it's interesting. I don't think we've ever raised our voices to each other. And out of that relationship has come four gorgeous kids that you saw here, all with a performance ability. Elise, Amy, Nick and Andre, I've put down here, each creative, each a good cook, each with a sense of humour, and each in joy and love of being part of the Rolfs family. And we're not blind to their faults. We're aware that there are things in each of them. But we are incredibly proud of each of those kids. And we're also proud and pleased because they've all made a special choice with partners, Dave, Chris, Sarah and Anathy, who we also love very much. And it's interesting looking at the parents of those four, their partners, that all of their parents have been married for over 40 years to the same person, which is really amazing. But yeah, we love our kids, we love their partners, and it's great. And then of course all of our gorgeous grandchildren, the nine of them who are all out there, not causing a riot at the moment, but that's lovely. And then you've also met the extended family, sort of, although really we could most of us fit into a telephone box. There's not many of us. Overall in my life, I just want to say, my past and my present, I have continued to experience the love and the blessing of God. As Helen said, I just loved school teaching, but I love pastoring. And people say retire, but I don't know what that really means. There was a photo in the paper of the Queen looking in the dictionary and Philip behind her. And Philip said, "I said retirement." And she said, "I know what you said, I'm looking up the meaning." And I have to say that I feel a little bit like that. I have said to him, "If I say the same thing in a sermon 5 times on Sunday morning, just tell me as we're driving home, love, it's time to give up." But we haven't quite got to that at this point. As we, Helen and I, and as I have seen the goodness and love of God in life, in our marriage and in our kids, it has made telling and teaching the truth of Jesus very, very easy. There was never anything I had to make up. There was never anything I had to pretend about. It was all just very, very easy. And it had to be direct and truthful and relevant. And of course, our prayer and hope would be that all of our friends know the truth and the love that comes through faith in Jesus. I do just want to say particularly that I know some of our friends here today have not been well. And I just want to reassure you that you, because you are our friends, you are especially in our hearts, our thoughts, and our prayers. And thank you for coming. You know who you are. So each of you here today has in some way influenced or affected me, made me think in another way, or supported me in some very special way. And I want to thank you all very much for that. Now, I've said there's stuff to take, but I would like, as a pastor, to pray before we have some more tucker. Let's pray. Our God, we thank you for the fun that we can share, for stories that are reminders of not only your faithfulness, but of who you are. And I thank you for all of these friends and family gathered here today who in some special way have influenced my life and in another way have honoured me today by being prepared to come and to spend this time. It's been very special. And I want to pray that your blessing would be upon each person gathered here today, particularly those who are not well, and pray your healing. For those who have heavy hearts or sadness, for those who are celebrating. But most of all, we thank you that you are the living God and our trust is in you. And Father, for all of these happy memories and for the celebration that we have the privilege of joining in together about, we want to thank you. And we thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen.